focuses on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech.
वार्षिक संवाददाता सम्मेलन में भाग लेने के लिए एकत्रित हुए हैं। आज इस मौके पर मैं मंच पर उपस्थित माननीय पुलिस आयुक्त महोदय एवं वरिष्ठ पुलिस अधिकारियों का स्वागत करता हूं और साथ ही इस सम्मेलन में भाग लेने आए सभी मीडिया के साथियों का विशेष अभिनंदन करता हूं। वर्ष 2017 में दिल्ली पुलिस ने आदरणीय पुलिस आयुक्त महोदय के नेतृत्व में कई नए आयाम स्थापित किए और जन सुरक्षा व कम्युनिटी पुलिसिंग की
Then towards the end, again I will get a chance to round it up. So if the presentation can be started now, we can. During the year 2017, we made a very sustained endeavor on many things. This was one of the main priority areas, that is, we should have more making the service delivery at the police stations more service oriented, and the approach to any complainant who comes to the police station also should be more of an empathetic kind. They should try to understand the problems and then facilitate their grievances. We focused on training and also on induction of technology so that we could have a trained and techno-savvy orientation as far as the Delhi police officers and personnel are concerned. And this is what I would like to highlight, that is, prevention was a critical focus area for us. We decided that crimes should be to the extent possible prevented, and obviously as and when they take place we investigate and then try to detect. But as compared to the earlier times where policemen were mostly reacting to situations, we thought we could plan, we could anticipate and focus on prevention so that the policing in Delhi concerned. So we focused on tackling it, safety of women and vulnerable groups, people friendly and responsive policing. As I have to notice, we came down quite heavy on the concerned staff. Anti-terror measures were again an area of focus because, as you would know, across the globe we had incidents in other countries which made us think and plan appropriately so that we can create the necessary atmosphere of prevention and deterrence. Traffic, as you know, has all along been a problem in Delhi on account of the number of vehicles which are there on the road and the lack of timely access which they in any case have to in a city like Delhi. But obviously their morale has to be kept high, necessary welfare measures also will have to be initiated so that the police personnel of the lower ranks, they have a feeling that they are being well taken care of by the supervisory commissions. This year, that is the year 2017, last year, we took some special initiatives, which you can see. These were very carefully thought about innovations, I would say. For instance, in vulnerable areas, we inducted women beat officers, particularly in areas like universities, schools, colleges. Then we took this self-defense training to a newer height by bringing it under the banner of Sashakti, where we thought that since majority of those found involved in the street riot are youngsters, 95% almost are first timers, then we thought that beyond the normal policing and bringing them under the ambit of the criminal justice system, there has to be some innovative thinking to plan it on a long-term basis so that those who are on the verge of thinking to get into the world of delinquency, they could be identified in time and brought under the scheme of skill development so that they are mainstream in the society and to that extent they are weaned away from the world of delinquency. Child-friendly rooms were introduced in selected police stations and we propose to take it forward by starting in more police stations. Then the last you see on the screen was a very unique thing which was started called Prahari. We realized that the security guards, the private security personnel, chowkidars, who are employed in various areas of Delhi, they were not well sort of the backbone of policing. They are the backbone of policing, but it had to be sort of conveyed to them in certain measure that yes, you are the ones who are at the cutting edge level, you have to perform better. Keeping this in mind, I made it a point to go and have a personal interaction with beat officers in all the districts during the year. And we told them, yes, this is what is expected of you, and this is how you should perform in times to come. High visibility and professionalism, which again was a key area during 2017. And the last thing also, as I mentioned earlier, two schemes like Neighborhood Watch Scheme, Prahari, Eyes and Ears Scheme, we wanted the community to participate in our policing efforts in a bigger way, and we have achieved to a large extent success in this. We may think of even carrying it forward in the year 2018. So hereafter I would like to hand over to Specialty Crime to
the crime rate, which is crime incidence per lakh of population, has also seen a slight increase. From 1137, it has gone to 1263. But we have analyzed it and studied it. And the reason for the increase in IPC crime,
mentioned about this public facilitation officer scheme. This is a unique scheme which was started during 2017. We have what is called a public facilitation desk where a JD officer preferably is manning that desk, and to make her interface with the complainant more friendly, we made it a point that she should not be dressed in police uniform. So it's a civilian kind of prescribed dress which she is required to wear, and she is the one who will talk to the visitor at the police station, find out what is the requirement, and accordingly facilitate. Child-friendly police stations, I also mentioned right in the beginning that we have sometimes visitors who have children with them. Sometimes even we have children victims coming to the police stations. So it was quite necessary that we have a room where the child is made very comfortable so that he or she is in a position to narrate what exactly she has got to tell the police. And it was important for us to realize that the child, by virtue of the requirement of coming to a police station, may actually be slightly sort of psychologically in a low state. So the best kind of atmosphere that is provided to him or her at the police station is going to help us in finding out what he or she has to say. This I mentioned right at the beginning, we spared no one who came to any adverse notice when it comes to corruption or aberrations. You will find that, you know, we identified certain categories of complaints which have a direct impact on the police image, and when it came to handling those complaints, we made sure that we did a very prompt inquiry and we took very, very appropriate action, sometimes deterrent action in case the aberration was found to be of a serious nature. These figures will all be there, and in the next slide you will see that the details are there. We have not hesitated even to invoke Article 311 in selected cases where we thought the aberration or the instance of corruption was of a blatant kind, so we did not spare those flashing. This is one thing which you are only the media, and we have not publicized so many other instances of good work which have happened where the armed janta is the victim. If you come to, if you see the crime data, the performance of the year 2017, you will realize that all the burglary and snatchings are not considered in the heinous category. They are still given the kind of importance they deserve. So under both the heads, if you see the performance of the year 2017 is way above the year 2016. So obviously not all these cases would be the kind you are talking. They are cases which are of the armed janta. So I don't think it's a kind of perception only, but these two heads of crime, we do realize that they affect the people as much as possibly would have been a crime. So we are giving them equal importance.